How are you all? Let's start with our today's class. So before starting that, let's see what is our today's thought. Knowing is not enough, we must apply. Willing is not enough, we must do. What is the meaning of today's thought? Well, only knowing the things is not enough. We must also know the application. We must know how to use it. The same way, only showing willingness is not enough. We must first do it. So let's follow this thought precisely and continue with our lesson by learning about asteroids. As you can see here, asteroids are nothing but the small and big pieces of rocks. So they are made up of rocks. But where is you see all these asteroids? Well, you see a band or belt of numerous such heavenly bodies, that is asteroids, rocks, specifically between the planets Mars and Jupiter. So we can say that a band of numerous small heavenly bodies between the planet Mars and Jupiter is called the belt of asteroids. Again, I want to repeat this. A band of numerous small heavenly bodies. Band, a belt. A band of numerous small heavenly bodies. But where do you see this belt or band of heavenly bodies? Specifically between the planets Mars and Jupiter is said to be the belt of asteroids. Now this definition becomes more clear in the next slide. See children, as you can see here, this is the belt of asteroids. And this belt of asteroids is very clear and prominent between the planets Mars and Jupiter. So what are asteroids? Basically a band of heavenly bodies between the planets Mars and Jupiter is called the belt of asteroids. Now in the last lesson, children, I ask you one question, that why these planets keeps on moving around the sun? Why don't they fall down? Why they follow a specific orbit? Why don't they fall down? Is there anything which holds all these planets together, which keeps them moving around the sun? Yes. In the last lesson, we talked something about the gravitational force. Isn't it? As you can see here, all these planets are moving around the sun. So what the sun does? Sun exerts a force of attraction on all these planets. So what sun does? It tries to attract all these planets towards itself. Whereas what is the tendency of all these planets? They try to move away from the sun. So here there are two forces, isn't it? Sun is attracting all planets towards itself, whereas all these planets are moving away from the sun. So as a result of these two forces, these planets keeps on moving around the sun. See, it is written here, sun pull all the planets towards itself, whereas all planets try to move away from sun. And due to the combined effect of these two forces, planets move around the sun. Let's talk something about the space, empty space, isn't it? But here, when we are talking about the heavenly bodies, the emptiness between and beyond the stars and planets is called the space or outer space. As you can see here, stars, twinkling stars, shining stars, but there is some empty dark space, isn't it? This we call as a space or outer space. If you see the previous slide, no children, here also we can see that emptiness, isn't it? This emptiness between the planets and beyond the planets. So emptiness again between the stars and beyond the stars and planets is said to be the space or outer space. Again we will read this definition. The emptiness or empty space between and beyond the stars and planets is called the space or outer space. I hope you understand the meaning of space. If we want to study really about these heavenly bodies, planets, stars, so with what we can study all these planets? Well, for that you need a space launch technology. So what is this space launch technology? Do you need something? Yes, we need certain objects to study about this planet. So which are these objects? As you can see here, rockets, isn't it? So sending such objects into the space to study about the planets, to study about the space, it is called as the space launch technology. So here also we are sending some objects or rockets into the space. But how these rockets move into the space? Well, they work against the force of attraction. That is, they work against the gravitational force of attraction. They literally have to fight with the gravitational force of attraction, and then only we can launch rockets into the space. So this whole thing is the space launch technology. Sending some objects into the space which work against the force of gravity. So basically what we have learned in today's short lesson? Well, we have learned something about the definition of asteroids. So what are asteroids? A band of numerous small heavenly bodies between Mars and Jupiter is said to be the belt of asteroids. As you know, Sun exerts gravitational force of attraction on all planets, whereas all planets, they try to move away from the Sun. As a result of these two forces, planets move around the Sun. The empty space or emptiness between and beyond the stars and planets is called space or outer space. So what is our today's homework, children? You have to write down all points which we have seen just now under the heading what we have learned for how many times? 3 times in your notebook, and learn well. So whatever homework we are giving, children, just have a writing practice of that and learn very well. So this is what about our today's short lesson. We will again meet in the next lesson. Till then, bye. And do your homework regularly. Don't forget. Okay, children. Bye for now.